Legends of Sri Aurobindo from the book The Mother, Part 2, Letters on the Mother by Our Lord, Chapter 5, Opening and Surrender to the Mother, Page 129, Topic, Loyalty and Fidelity to the Mother. Sri Aurobindo says, if an adverse force comes, one has not to accept and welcome its suggestions, but to turn to the mother and to refuse to turn away from her. Whether one can open or not, one has to be loyal and faithful. Loyalty and fidelity are not qualities for which one has to do yoga. They are very simple things which any man or woman who aspires to be truth ought to be able to accomplish. The next topic, the only way to succeed, Sri Aurobindo says, there is in a very fundamental part of your nature a strong formation of ego individuality which has mixed in your spiritual aspiration a clinging element of pride and spiritual ambition. This formation has never consented to be broken up in order to give place to something more true and divine. Therefore, when the mother has put her force upon you, or when you yourself have pulled the force upon you, this in you has always prevented it from doing its work in its own way. It has begun itself building according to the ideas of the mind or some demand of the ego, trying to make its own creation in its own way, by its own strength, its own sadhana, its own tapasya. There has never been any real surrender, any giving up of yourself freely and simply into the hands of the Divine Mother. And yet, that is the only way to succeed in the supramental yoga. To be a yogi, a sannyasi, a tapasvi is not the object here. The object is transformation, and the transformation can be done by a force infinitely greater than your own. It can only be done by being truly like a child in the hands of the Divine Mother. Everyone who's turned to the mother is doing my yoga. It is a great mistake to suppose that one can do the Purna Yoga, that is, carry out and fulfill all the sides of the yoga by one's own effort. No human being can do that. What one has to do is to put oneself in the mother's hands and open oneself to her by service, by bhakti, by aspiration. Then the mother, by her light and force, works in him so that the sadhana is done. It is a mistake also to have the ambition to be a big Purna Yogi or a supramental being and ask oneself how far have I got towards that. The right attitude is to be devoted and given to the mother and to wish to be whatever she wants you to be. The rest is for the mother to decide and do in you. April 1935. If there is a refusal of the psychic new birth, a refusal to become the child newborn from the mother, owing to the attachment to the intellectual knowledge or mental ideas or to some vital desire, then there will be a failure in the sadhana. Question. In our sadhana, at times, we experience large descents of peace, force, ananda, etc., which are usurped by our little human ego to make us feel that we shall belong to the mother's select band of supermen. Is this not a mistake? For this, Sri Aurobindo says, to want to be a superman is a mistake. It only swells the ego. One can aspire for the divine to bring about the supramental transformation, but that also should not be done till the being has become psychic and spiritualized by the descent of the mother's peace, force, light and purity. 22nd February 1936. Next question. What poise or mood should we keep for the supramental descent? For this, Sri Aurobindo says, as for the poise or mood, that you need not trouble yourself about. An entire faith, opening, self-giving to the mother are the only conditions necessary throughout. Date 23-9-1935. Next topic, the vital's resistance to surrender. Sri Aurobindo says, I have said that the human vital does not like to be controlled or dominated by another, and I said that also was a reason why sadhaks find it difficult to surrender to the mother. For the vital wants to affirm its own ideas, impulses, desires, preferences and do what it likes. It does not want to feel another force than that of its own nature leading or driving it. But surrender to the mother means that it must give up all these personal things and allow her force to guide and drive it in the ways of a higher truth, which are not its own ways. So it resists, does not want to be dominated by the truth light, and the mother's force insists on its own independence and refuses to surrender. These ideas of breakdown and personal frustrations are again wrong suggestions, and the dissatisfaction with yourself is as harmful almost as dissatisfaction with a mother would be. It prevents the confidence and courage necessary for following the path of the sadhana. You must dismiss these suggestions from you. Date 8-10-1936.